The Olympic Shooting Centre in Cyprus. The skeet athletes have departed, so have the strong winds, which should make it easier for the trap shooters in today's finals, although it has clouded over. Beautiful day this morning. Sun was out, a few pink faces amongst the athletes, who perhaps called out by just how strong this, April the 1st sunshine is. No joke for them, but we do have our finals about to get underway. The weather not as warm, but it feels warmer because there is, of course, not the strong winds. It's getting a bit blustery at the moment, but nothing too terrible. And we are set to get ourselves underway here at the Olympic Shooting Centre. As you can see, the flags not stiff on the mast as they have been the last few days. And so I think slightly more benign conditions, if truth be told. Our athletes in the women's trap competition are about to be introduced to us. And Petros is going to do the honours in the arena. The man who has several hats in terms of his responsibilities. Technical direction, director, competition manager, and also announcer here. It's great to have him around and helping us all out. So, eight athletes have made it through from qualification. From one, actually down to nine in qualification, because Marika Patera of Italy was there for ranking points only, and she came eighth, 19-year-old. Some golds in junior mixed team and team competitions at World Championship and Junior Cup level, so it'll be interesting to see her, I'm sure, at some stage on the final stage. But it was good luck for Lucy Hall, who came ninth and squeaked in. So we're about to get underway. Here are the athletes for ranking match number one. Augusta Campos Martin of Puerto Rico.
Representing Portugal, Maria Inés Coelho de Barros.
From Portugal, Maria Coelho de Barros, the 21-year-old. We have seen her take the World Cup silver in Baku last year. Very bubbly personality.
Representing China, Quincy Wu.
And China have come out and been very impressive as a team over this week. And Wu Chui Chui, the 35-year-old from the Henan province. World Cup gold, of course, in Changwon last year. Slightly longer commute for this final. And Fatima Galvez, top of the pile, the reigning Olympic champion, of course, a 36-year-old from Buena in Cordoba. That's ranking match number one.
Charlotte Hall Lucy.
Lucy Hall, just 19 years of age. What a career she has ahead of her. World Cup bronze in Changwon last year, a junior European champion in 21 in Osijek. Next year, it was a senior silver for her. Rachel Tozier is 31 today. Happy birthday to Rachel Tozier. Nothing wrong with being 31. Got past the trauma of being 30. The decade where you're old enough to know better and you're young enough to get on and do it. Four World Cup golds, all in team and mixed team for her. And Sandra Bernal is the next up from Poland, the 23-year-old. The World Cup gold in Nicosia a couple of years ago. So like Cyprus. And last but by no means least, from Australia, Penny Smith, the 27-year-old, world ranked number one. Three World Cup golds, two team, one mixed team, including Doha this year and Nicosia last year. So those are our eight athletes. Our jury member in charge is from Italy.
For ranking match one, Mr. Alfie Skitter is from Cyprus.
And our referee, as you heard, I'm sure, is from Cyprus. Alkis Katiris, very imposing physical presence, is a tall man. Emir Saade, also from Cyprus.
Ladies and gentlemen, let the ranking matches begin.
So if you can see, there is a bit of cloud around. The wind turbines are still turning, but not as stiffly as they were for the Skeet athletes as we get ready for our first ranking match. Two ranking matches then, of course. 15 targets for them. And then we lose our fourth athlete. And then after 25 targets, we will lose our third athlete. The top two to the medal match. We repeat that again. And this is the lineup for our first one. And Galvez in sparkling form in qualifications, three targets ahead of Penny Smith, who was next closest. 118 for her, 115 for Smith, all the way down to Lucy Hall, who squeaked in on 112. Quick shot of Matt Coward-Holly on the coach's bench. Matt Coward-Holly, I'm sure, will be looking for Olympic glory. He's been in good form the last few years for Great Britain. Busy day here at the Olympic shooting range, not just here at the Olympic venue. Oh, by the way, just in the background, you can see the range dog taking it all in his or her stride. We'd love to see that dog. But yeah, there are sporting and compact ranges away to our left. Had a little stroll up there this morning. It was full of locals out enjoying their hobby, including one lad who was so young. I think his shotgun was probably taller than he was. They start them young here in Cyprus, in sports shooting. Test fire first of all, so the athletes can get used to the conditions. That's our boss of the event, Bodo. Keeping an eye, making sure things run smoothly. Just having a little look at the targets. Remember, in the 15, they'll get one to the left, one to the right, and one straight away down the middle-ish. Spain must be confident. But you never know. Got to get through to the final first, and then you've got to make sure you're on the podium. Takes a while for the denouement. So we'll start with the test fire, then we're underway. Galvez. That Olympic gold in Tokyo, of course, 5 World Cup golds and 20 medals all told. Wu Chui Chui, World Cup gold, as you mentioned, last year. A couple of Grand Prix golds as well last year, so she's in decent nick, the woman from Henan. Maria Coelho de Barros. Just 21, it's a okay, so we've got quite a few youngsters, 3 in their 20s, 1 in their just 19. Matt Coward-Holly in the coach's chair at the moment. Not his day in the men's competition, but there'll be another one, of course. We are underway. Galvez starts us off with a miss. Not a great start for the Olympic champion. Well, at the moment, no one seems to want to join the party. That's better. From Coelho de Barros, the Portuguese athlete. Yeah. Representing South America and Puerto Rico. Campos Martin starts well. Remember, 15 targets, so three times around the five shooting positions. Oh dear, what is going on with Galvez? Way high to the left for the Chinese athlete. No problems this time. So it is Galvez who is bottom of the pile at the moment, but it may well change. Down the middle for Coelho de Barros. Now Campos Martin. World Cup silver in Lenato last year and a team bronze in Lenato. And she'll make her way around to shooting position one. That was a nasty one away to the right, but this time no problem for Galvez. It's not insurmountable. She knows that as well. Missing the first couple. Oh, that one rose a little bit. Remember these targets. They can go left to right between 0 and 45 degrees. And then, of course, at 10 metres away, they can be anything from 1.5 to 3 metres high. That's all decided on. There are 9 tables and one will be chosen at random. Well, Galvez back on it a little bit, but Coelho de Barros certainly has come out of the traps really well. Can she continue away on that left hand side? That's not so bad. Campos Martin just following through with that shotgun. The arc after she's pulled the trigger. Way to the right for the Spaniard. Galvez, 3 in a row after that poor opening. Not a difficult one. Straight down the middle for the Portuguese. 5 out of 5. Can Campos Martin join her in that particular party? Yes, she can. Nicely done. 10 more targets before we lose our first athlete, of course. Galvez. Well, she's been around the block long enough, the world number 8, to know it's not over just yet. There will be more misses, but we did start, didn't we? With a sprinkling of reds for her and Wu Chi Chi. And there's another one. It's not happening for Galvez today. Top qualification, of course. Across to the left, Coelho de Barros, no problem at all. A little bit easier for the right-hander to go right to left. You're pulling rather than pushing. Unblemished so far, the Portuguese, the Puerto Rican. Perfect conditions, it's not that windy. Although the sun is not out, it's not terrible visibility. If it stays cloudy, might be a bit of a challenge in the men's final later on. Hope you can join us for that. That's after the women's competition has concluded. And there we go. The first red for the woman from Puerto Rico, Augusta Campos Martin. Yeah. Well, something's not right. Something has to be awry for Galvez to be missing like this. Missed 4, hit 4. Maybe something technical. Perhaps it's something other in the mind. I don't know. You would think not, wouldn't you, with Galvez? And a second miss in a row for Campos Martin. Galvez looking to get back on it, does, with one that is fairly low and to the right. Woo now. Puff of the powder is what they're looking for, of course, inside these flash targets. Portuguese, I was about to say the only one without a miss, but that's her first miss. May get interesting as we go around again. A yellow card from the referee to the Chinese athlete. I'm not sure that's because she was moving. Anyway, the Puerto Rican can set up again. 12 seconds, of course, to set up. Call for the target. Now all on her own on this right-hand side. This time, better from Galvez. Behind, even though she has shot one more. So there's a bit of work to do if she's to stay in the competition. Well, that was a tricky one. Really was low and really wide on the right-hand side. So three misses out of four for Campos. Martin brings her from a share of the lead down into third place with Wu Tre Tre. With that yellow card, just a warning. No points deducted. Didn't see a green card. But she's in second, she'll be happy enough. Not much you can do as coach at this point, and you do wonder what's changed between qualification and the final. Another miss. Only six hits and five misses. It's not the percentage that Galvez is used to, that's for sure. Now Campos Martin. That's better from her. A couple in a row get her back on track. Double figures for Coelho de Barros. Now the Puerto Rican. Two, of course, remember going through. It's very unlikely to be Fatima Galvez. The coach has got one of those resigned looks on his face, doesn't he? Now Barros, Coelho de Barros, just leading from Wu by one. And I was about to say, surely Campos Martin has done enough to get herself into the next stage, if nothing else. But you do wonder, with that miss, that's four misses out of the last six after being really good nip before that. Certainly good form from the Portuguese. Just 21 years of age. Back to Galvez. Struggling is the Olympic champion. Very nearly at the end of our first part of this relay. Fourth place will be decided. for 15 targets. Straight down the middle. Nice and benign. For Campos Martin. Well, Galvez will be hoping Campos Martin. Well, you shouldn't wish ill on her competitor, I'm sure, but if Campos Martin misses, Galvez will be able to squeak through into the next part of this competition. She's hit four in a row, and she just needed a bit of a run, didn't she, really? So pressure on Campos Martin here. No problem at all. Under pressure. And so, the woman with number one on her back, the Olympic champion. Not going to be her day today. She topped qualification by quite some distance. But, well, who knows? There will be a debrief, I am sure of that. That's a bit of a surprise, to be fair. And Campos Martin with a bit to do now. We have another 10 targets. As my papers go flying in a sudden gust of wind. You may have heard a bit of discombobulation. It's all right, they're all back under my control. Well, I say control, I'm holding on to them tightly. That, there obviously is a bit of breeze still blowing through from time to time. The flags of the sideline referee fluttering as well. So perhaps we're just getting a little bit more challenging conditions. We go through to 25 targets and then we'll know who'll be taking their place in that final. Not Galvez, that's for sure. That's the surprise of the day so far. VIP seats filled, and like I said, a busy day here. The restaurant and rest area, very full, bustling. Wu Cheche, just I think having a slight issue, but everything's okay. See how fast those targets come out of the bunker. 76 meters they will reach if they're not broken first, of course. Miss. A miss from Coelho de Barros, which gives the others some hope. We Cheche level with her. Still time, perhaps, for Campos Martin to catch up. Way to the left this time. Some of these athletes will be counting, some not. Referee just asking the Chinese athlete to stay where she was. Remember, she's already had a yellow card. You gotta do what you're told. She obviously wants to get around as soon as possible. She will be the next target, of course, to take. But a bit of a commute round to station number one. All the while getting your mind cleared, getting your mind ready. Didn't do too much in way of interfering with her mental sereneness. Nice, nothing too taxing for Barros there. Coelho de Barros, now Campos Martin. That was a tricky one. Just dipping a bit in the breeze. So, it is Wu Coelho de Barros.
Augusta Rose Campos Martin with 16 hits. We move to the next 5 targets for the end of round 2.
Matt Coward Holly Here's the coach for his partner. I think I'm right saying fiance. Anyway, you're sure to correct me if I got that wrong. You'll know that Campus Martin, it's just a little bit up against it at the moment. Target's running out. One more go around the five for these athletes. Nasty one to the left, but easily bagged by Wu, who's looking in good form here. Puts the pressure back on to Coelho de Barros. And they are going well. Wu missing the first and the third of her set here, and nothing since then. Coelho de Barros hitting her first eight and then hitting red. So it is Campus Martin who is just struggling a wee bit. One of the stars of this World Cup. In the final stages, you really don't have much room for mistakes. And there's another one from Coelho de Barros this time. I think the message is you need one more and you're through. One more. Campus Martin. Well, you never know. Whoa. It's a miss. On 21. We'll make it through. Especially now, with that miss, now Campus Martin. Can she take it to a shoot-off? Well, we've got a couple of targets left for her. One from everybody else. Yeah, that's not the time to miss. Could have really put the pressure on the Portuguese. Still a chance to take it to a shoot-off. Wu Trey is through, but she liked to go through first, like a good bib number in the final. Nicely done. A little round of applause from the crowd behind her. And that's the important one, and the coach knows it, and so do the supporters behind. And that's confirmation then that Campus Martin, Puerto Rico, will not make it through. She takes third place. It is Wu of China, Coelho de Barros, who will go through, the Portuguese athlete. Not quite then for Campus Martin. It was close, but not close enough. And it is Wu and Coelho de Barros who will go through. And we will find out the two who will join them in just a minute, because the ranking match number two is coming up.
Thank you.
for athletes of ranking match 2 had the rank for test fire.
So there we go, ranking match number 2. That's the start list: Australia, Poland, United States, and Great Britain. The test firing just getting underway as the turbines continue to twist and turn. 21 of them I counted on the way in on the hilltops around here. And if you get up close to them, they do make the most odd whooshing noises, almost like there's an aeroplane overhead. Four athletes looking to join. The two athletes already through, Wu and Coelho de Barros. Jay Waldron and Richard Salmon next to each other. There's a little bit of hijinks between those two. It's all got out of hand since some jokes were played, some pranks were played in Tokyo, and was being filled in with what's been going on. I'm not sure who's going to win that particular battle of wills, but I'll keep you filled in as the season goes on. We're underway. Smith, Bernal, Tozier, all starting well. This is Lucy Hall, the 19-year-old from Great Britain. Only been competing 5 years, but then, of course, she's only 19. From Moulton, which, if my geography is correct, is in Derbyshire. I'm sure those in Moulton who may be watching will put me right. There's Richard Salmon watching Penny Smith bag another one. Now, the Polish athlete Bernal, the 23-year-old, World Cup gold in Nicosia a couple of years ago here in Cyprus. Took my first trip up to Nicosia yesterday. Interesting place, good food. Very good food. Lots of it as well. Everyone starting well. Better start, really, than we saw in the first competition, the first ranking match, where Galvez and Wu started poorly. Straight down the middle as the sun comes out in the conditions. Just improve a little bit. Happy birthday, by the way, to Rachel Tozier. That's not a present you'd want to see. 31 today, as we mentioned, if you were with us right at the beginning. And Hall joins the party of missing. Station 4 for the left-hander. The Australian won't get much easier a target than that. 4 out of 4 at the moment. Smith qualifying second behind Galvez. A shot ahead of Wu and Bernal, who had to be separated by a very brief shoot-off. Jay Waldron, for once, has got his serious face on. Lucy Hall back in to the green. 15 targets, remember, then we lose our first of these four athletes. Well, there's light enhancing glasses. You can see Tanya's got a slightly lighter pair on top of her baseball cap. Lucy Hall not bothering with the cap. And looking good. Couple on 5, couple on 4. It's still very tight. Marco Micheli, Italian British coach, will be hoping that Hall can overcome that one shot deficit. Smith and Bernal on 5, Tozier and Hall on 4. Long old way to go, though. Another 10 targets for these athletes. Bernal, tallest of the four, just, I think, may Maybe Hall. Have to do what you do in the playground, back to back. Get someone to decide, no tiptoes. Because that's just cheating. Oh, that was a rotten old target for Tozier. Away dipping to the right-hand side. Down the middle for Charlotte Hall, much better for her. It's Tozier who trails. Nicely done. It's a touch to the left for the left-hander. That was rising all the time, but nicely done. It was interesting to go up the road and see the various kinds of recreational shooting, the sports shooting, the compact shooting, coming out from all over the place, not bunkers, but top of the hill, side of the hill, coming towards you. And the locals are having a great time. I say the locals, there are a few hire cars up there, a few people on holiday having a go as well. But this is a very different kettle of fish. That was a nasty old target and a first miss for Penny Smith. Rising to the left, not such a good target. Ooh, now there was definitely a bit of dust on that. Definitely a bit of dust on that. The side referee nearest to me said that there was. It is green. Here's Tozier. Nothing on that one, though. No, a thumbs up from the referee. Did seem there was a very faint puff. That's the faint there for Lucy Hall. Gonna have eyes like hawks if you're a referee. That one came out broken. I think we'll have to go again. The puff of pink smoke from the bunker. Not once it has gone. No problems this time. Well, she had a fair idea where it was going as well, didn't she? Bernal leading the pack. That's her first miss, though. And she's pegged back level with Penny Smith. Tozier one behind with those couple of misses and a chance for Hall to make it eight as well. And she does. This far side for Penny Smith. Nicely done. Really has concentration etched in that face, even when she's not. She's walking from position five down to one. Look how high the elbow is there for Tozier. Looking to get back into this. That's nicely done. Now Lucy Hall. Good championship bronze last year. But a miss there leaves her just one off. And she has, of course, the lowest bib number of this competition, this semi-final, this ranking match. So she'll be wanting to get back into the green again. A couple of misses for her, a couple of misses for Tozier. Just the one apiece for Penny Smith and Sandra Bernal. Bernal with the miss. So Penny Smith has a slight advantage over everybody else. It's a very distinct stance, isn't it, for Tozier. Now Hall, straight as a rod, and she wanders across, throwing the empty cartridge into the bin. Still cross with that miss last time out. And she knows she's the one at a disadvantage on the bib number if it comes to it, but a miss. That's two in a row for Sandra Bernal, and all of a sudden, she's in a spot of bother. Tozier, it's down the middle, but it's high, and it's missed. Jay Waldron can't quite believe it. Tricky one, dispatched from Lucy Hall. Oh, look how it's changed. Hall down to second place. Get to 15 targets, someone's got to make way. Tozier has the lower bib number if it's between Bernal and Tozier. Down the middle, travelling at speeds well in excess of 100 kilometres an hour. Nicely done, and again that distinctive snap to get the empty cartridge out from Lucy Hall. Bernal putting the double miss, she would hope, behind her, but no. Goodness me, three out of four and four out of six in the red for the Polish athlete, who was cruising quite nicely. It's come off the rails slightly now. Smith still looking good. Lucy Hall has pulled it back as well, the great British athlete. Oh, and a miss from Smith. A miss from Smith. At this stage, doesn't matter. Another 10 targets, though, after this. That was a riser, and Tozier. Well, you can see the reaction from her. Slightly deflated. You can see the reaction from Jay Waldron as well. And Hall finishes nicely the first part of this second ranking match. Well, it wasn't to be for the birthday girl. Rachel Tozier can relax and look forward, I guess, to some celebrations anyway tonight. Fourth place in this second ranking match for her. Same number of targets as Bernal, but Bernal had one higher bib number, and that was enough. Fine margins, isn't it, this sport? Fine margins. Another 10 targets then before we know who goes through, and then we'll have the medal match. Absolute concentration from Hall. Level with Smith. Bernal with a bit of work to do. Good from the left-hander. Putting pressure on everybody else. A long all day for the teams. For Richard Salmon, the coach. Another miss from Bernal. Well, the gap is widening. Richard, the Australian coach, electrical contractor, but decided to make the switch after being an assistant coach for a while. And he said this morning, we were having a chat about 10 o'clock this morning, and he was saying how much he really loves his job. A lot of travel involved, but a lot of I guess job satisfaction, and so far he'll be satisfied with the progress of Penny Smith. Lucy Hall in a good run of form. That's what, eight in a row for her. It's a great shot, just showing the speed of reaction and how fast those targets do disappear into the great beyond. No target caught. I think that was just because, possibly because the Polish athlete was walking behind the referee, just asking it to hold station. Slight delay for the British athlete, but no worries. Slightly to the right. Cloud rolling over again. Darkened the skies and provide a little challenge, extra challenge for these athletes. Smith in a good run now of five. Asking the question of the other two. This is slightly, I think it's fair to say, never say never, but it was, what, 22 and 21 to get yourself through in the last final. Penny Smith, next up. Last five before we know. You'd put your money at the moment, wouldn't you, on the Australian and the British athlete. But now, well, you get five here, you never know. You never know. But each target that Smith and Hall break, the closer they get. And also, they'll be looking for the best bib number they possibly can. Set up meticulous. A tricky one for Bernal, but she dealt with it very well. The 23-year-old, that World Cup gold in Nicosia. Doesn't look like it's going to be repeated here. Three targets left, she's three behind. She's also got a Junior European Championship mixed team gold in Lenarte, so she knows her way to the podium, does the Polish athlete, but it looks like it's going to be Australia and Great Britain who will go through in this particular round. This from Smith. Bernal closes the gap. Hall can open up a lead. No, it's a miss from her as well. Breeze is still noticeable, but certainly nothing like the ski athletes had to deal with. Goodness me, that was a tricky old final, wasn't it? Clay's careering everywhere in the wind. Oh, Bernal asking the question. The other two were perhaps worrying. A little wobble from Smith and Hall. But they've both done enough now. It's a question of who might top the rankings. Get the best bib number is a big advantage, of course. In the final, nicely done from Smith. Bernal will be wanting to continue her good form. This will be an eighth in a row. It's not going to be enough, though.
After 25 targets,
it is Smith and Hall, who go through
22
hits apiece. So it is the Polish athlete who has to make way, and we now know who will be in the final. Penny Smith, Lucy Hall go through impressively so. Galvez, Campos Martin are the other two. I beg your pardon, Wu and Coe de Baros are the other two to go through. Galvez and Campos Martin missing out as well. And in this one, it's Bernal and Tozier who miss out. So United States, for once, not getting through into the final stages. We'll be right back.
gentlemen, welcome back for the medal match. We have women individual event. The medal match consists of 15 targets for round 1 for the first elimination and another 10 targets for round 2 and the second elimination. Another 10 targets for round 3 for the gold and silver medalists. Possibility of shoot-off after round 3 in case of a tie between the two shooters. Let's give a warm welcome to the finalists. With bib number 4 representing Portugal, Maria Inês Coelho de Barros.
Here we go then, final time for the women in the trap competition. 4 have made it through, including Maria Coelho de Barros. 21-year-old will be hoping for her first gold medal. Lucy Hall, the 19-year-old, another youngster, but with a composure beyond her years. Another one for whom this would be a first gold medal.
With bib number 2, representing China, Wu Chuikui.
Oh, Wu has done very well, hasn't she? Really impressed. Wu Chuikui, 35 years of age, got the gold last year, so she knows what it takes to go to the top step of the podium.
Penny Smith.
So Penny Smith, second in qualification, equal on 22 with Lucy Hall, but on a look at obviously where they qualified, she will have the best bib number, the 27-year-old, the world ranked number 1. One in Doha, Smith. We're looking for her 4th World Cup gold. Our officials make their way onto the field of play as well as we get ready for hopefully a nail biter. 4 left in. 15 targets first up, and we all know who has 4th. Another 10 targets for bronze and a further 10 targets. We'll decide who takes gold, who takes silver. Those are the 4 then. This is the stage here in Larnaca for the medal match. Australia, China, Great Britain and Portugal. Oh, with a chance of their anthem being played. We're underway with Smith and she starts well. Wu doesn't. Lucy Hall, a tricky one to start. And again, that snap of the wrist to put the empty cartridge into the basket. Very decisive, the way she goes about her business. The range dog is lounging around again. Just behind the field of play. Seen it all before. Wonderful creature. Often seen in the maintenance van, just hitching a lift. Just behind Lucy. No, just behind. Actually, Coelho de Barros. Sitting. Came to the shotgun. Referee who's doing the timings and just sat down to have a little tickle. I don't think the referee was going to do that, otherwise engaged. Good start from Smith. Wu, well, is the one who has the disadvantage at the moment, but bags that one nicely. Yeah, another little come on, I think she whispers to herself as she walks around Lucy Hall. She is pumped for this one. Just pauses as Coelho de Barros shoots from 1. She was walking back round. She's at station 1 now. Ooh, and there is a miss from Penny Smith. Down the middle. Not a problem for Wu Chuikui. Just the British athlete and the Portuguese. Unblemished record at the moment as the breeze comes flying through. There's a... no target, I think, for Coelho de Barros. Did see a target then just disappear into the distance. I don't think she called for it. There's a little look from one official to the other. To make sure it's reset properly. At the moment, targets are not coming out. I think one went and it shouldn't have done. And now I think we're reset now. And perhaps not surprisingly after that, there is a miss, but was that the right target? Well, she'll just have to put that behind her. So it is just Lucy Hall who has the green at the moment. Away high to the right, and Wu misses. And Hall joins the party as well. Away to the left it went. And another red, two in a row from Coelho de Barros. So at the moment, Smith and Hall, who were locked in battle in that second ranking match, are locked at the top here. Four for them, three for Wu and Coelho de Barros. Did well in the President's Cup last year, doing well here. Penny Smith starts this next set of five in good fashion, so does Wu. Oh, it's high and rising and being lifted by the breeze, and that's another miss, a second one in a row for Lucy Hall. Smith now with her nose in front. Well, it's getting tough out there. We had fairly plain sailing in that second ranking match. That was a tricky one for Wu, but she did well. Breeze is definitely getting up. You can see the lines. Referees' flags flapping, also the towels the athletes use to keep their hands dry. Oh, it's falling apart for the Portuguese at the moment. That's four in a row. And she walks back to station one. The coach just trying to get a message over to her. She was really, I think, distracted by the pause. A few targets earlier. Again, Lucy Hall departs quickly. And she gets one at last. Coelho de Barros back in the green, but a long way behind. Just to clarify what the problem was before, a gust of wind hit the microphone, which of course picked it up as a call to Paul. So the target was released, and of course then you've got to try and just reset the system completely to go back a shot. So that was the reason. And as you can see, one of the baskets has gone over in the breeze. So when we said the breeze had just kind of died down, we may have been speaking a little bit too soon. Chinese team in deep conversation. Wu is doing all right here, though. Aaron Smith on eight after Smith's miss. And another miss from Coelho de Barros. Well, she's a long way behind everyone else, neck and neck on eight. Only five targets left before we lose our fourth athlete, and I think it's just a poor day at the office. I think she was put off her stride a little bit from that delay she had when that target did release. And Smith with a miss. It's wide open at the moment, isn't it? It looks like it's Smith, Wu and Hall on the podium, but the question is in what order? And if Coelho de Barros hits all of her targets now, will she have any chance at all? Not if the others keep hitting. So Wu and Hall edge ahead. And another miss. It's not a good day to be a coach, is it, of the Portuguese athlete, and it's probably not a great to be out on the shooting positions. It's just fallen apart. Six misses out of eight. Penny Smith back in the green. Wu dealing with a difficult rising one to the left nicely. Put her hand up, thought it might have been called a miss, but the referee had seen it. And in Carbonaro, the Romanian, very experienced. Good to see a hit from the Portuguese. Down the middle it goes. Not a problem for Wu. Hit the last, what, eight in a row after missing two in the first five. Ooh, and a miss from Charlotte Hall puts her back down behind Wu. And that's, will confirm. De Barros, I thought that was a miss. Yeah, there we go, confirmation. Wu in great form. The Chinese shotgun team have been here in force and they've been impressive as well. Featured in the skeet finals. It's a good contest between Smith, Wu and Hall, but Coelho de Barros is the one trailing, is the one who will have to take fourth place. Now we're all on tender hooks here. Dog's just stretched out from sleep just in front of us. Very tight still between the leading three. Last target then for Maria Coelho de Barros. It's not going to be a podium for her. The 21-year-old had that World Cup final bronze in Cairo last year, World Cup silver in Baku. Not this time, fourth place. It's a difficult one, but well, the coach puts his arm around her. They will go and have a chat about it, I am sure. Just not at the races today. So that's our podium, but who will be top step of it? Well, we'll soon find out. Another 10 targets, twice around the five shooting positions for these athletes. It will go down to a bib number if needs be, which puts Lucy Hall at a disadvantage and Penny Smith at an advantage. Richard Salmon will be happy but nervous, like all coaches. Woo, excellent from her so far. It's as much mental now, isn't it, as it is physical. These athletes just got to take each shot as it comes, as the cliche goes, but it's certainly true, and Wu is looking in excellent form here. They all move one across. Smith will get us underway again. Target number 18 out of a possible 35 for someone. Someone will have to make way. Oh, and a miss from Smith. Side line referees agree as well. Well, Wu is certainly going well, isn't she? Can't remember the last time she missed. Wow. The wind is definitely picking up. It's just so difficult to keep your concentration when the furniture is moving. Exactly what Smith has to do, though. And they did very well. Another little bit of breeze coming through. Cooling down as well. I'm not sure these athletes will notice that too much in the heat of battle here. Nicely done. Pulling it away to the right hand side. A little easier for the left hander. Wu is a bit of a machine at the moment. Hall has been back in decent form as well.
After 20 targets, Shuiber from China is leading with 18 kids.
Likes Larnaca, did well in the European Championships last year. That silver was certainly perhaps the start of something special from the youngster. There's still a teenager, remember. Here we go again then. 25 targets. We'll see our bronze medal decided, and Smith with another miss. Rising, going away to the left, not a problem. Smith does have a bit of a problem. She's two behind Hall and three behind Wu, with time just running out on the Australian. No one from Camperdown likes horse riding, likes netball. I think likes shooting a little bit more. Oh, and there you go. She's human after all. The coach can't quite believe it. Well, gives Hall a chance to come level, and she does. Three left before we decide our bronze medalist. Now remember, if it comes to bib number, Smith has an advantage. Another gust coming through. The baskets are moving around again. There we are. Wind gusts of up to 14 metres per second. It's certainly not as easy as it was when they were in the ranking matches. Not a problem for Hall. Level with Wu. Smith, well, you can do the maths with two targets left. She needs both of these. That's an easy gimme down the middle for the Australian. Keeps her hopes alive. Wu, though, is back into the green again. There's the view from up top. Some of the Chinese contingent watching down intently. And it is going to be a bronze for Penny Smith, the 27-year-old. One in Doha. It's not going to be back-to-back wins, but a gold and a bronze at the beginning of the season. I think you'd take it, wouldn't you? Chinese are feeling not the heat, but the cold. Good finish for Smith. Wu has been outstanding. So has Lucy Hall as well. And it is the Australian who will take the bronze. Penny Smith, an excellent day's work. Richard Salmon will congratulate her. Well, had the advantage early on, but she did in the end have to make way, and it is another 10 targets to see who will take the gold and who will take the silver. If they're tied, it'll be a shoot-off. Can have that golden target if one athlete is too far ahead to be caught in the remaining targets. That's all a little bit ahead of us, but a miss from Wu to start this head-to-head. The sky is the limit. Well, she certainly believes in herself, does 19-year-old Lucy Hall. And another miss. Oh, my word. Well, she has been in such good form. And Lucy Hall moves two ahead. Wow, what a swing in fortunes that has been. Back into the green. The one that goes away to the right hand side. Hardly bear to watch. Smith watching on, like the rest of us, with the bronze already assured. But we are watching this battle. Hall at the moment is the one who is the happier of the two. Whether she's looking at the scoreboard or not is another matter. Some do, some don't. Almost identical from station 5 as the target that we got from station number 4. And that's a miss. That's a horror. It went really low and wide. So back to one, the advantage. But it is an advantage. Better from Wu. Back into some kind of form there, isn't she? Five more to go. It's tight. Had success in the Grand Prix as well as in the World Cup. Both of these in or on the podium in Changwon last year. Wu with the gold, Hall with the bronze. Fairly benign target for Wu. What will Hall have to contend with here? Four left, one the advantage. Shoot off if it's all level at the end of 35 targets. Oh, she did well there. She did really well there. It was a horrible, low, wide target to the right. That one a riser for Lucy Hall. Three to go. Oh, and a miss, a miss. Oh, now then. This is a really important target for Lucy Hall. And she bags it, so at least a shoot off. At least a shoot off. If she bags the next one, she has the gold. Oh, and it's a miss, and that should wrap it up. Will they give it the golden target? Yes, they will. And it is Lucy Hall who doesn't have to shoot again. And the smile there, the 19-year-old wins her first World Cup gold medal. And the British athlete, well, she held on to the coattails of that woman there, Wu, who just after a great middle part of the competition just faded a little bit towards the end, and she will take a very well-earned silver medal to go with that gold last year as well. Very tight finish to that competition, but Lucy Hall it is who takes the gold medal for Great Britain. And at last there is a smile from the youngster from Moulton. These are the three who are on the podium. The dark clouds roll over, but it's all gold for Lucy Hall. Here's confirmation then. Penny Smith for the bronze, Wu Chui Chui with the silver, and Lucy Hall takes the gold. big smile from Lucy Hall as she won the gold, and a big smile here as well. Congratulations, your first World Cup gold.
Thank you so much. Yeah, just wow, what a trip to Cyprus. Yeah, no, it's been absolutely fantastic.
How do you feel after what was quite a tense final?
Yeah, just towards the end I had to keep hitting and kind of let's see what happens. But no, it's been a great trip all round. And it's nice to have Nathan in the semi-final as well, so let's hope he can go and smash it.
Difficult for you in a way, because Wu was really, she was in great form in the middle of that competition, and you were sort of trailing a little bit, but I guess you just had to keep hoping.
Yeah, keep hoping and keep going, and yeah, never give up, for sure.
And the conditions sort of deteriorated as the competition went on.
Yeah, it was getting a bit blowy, but that's why we do the winter training back in England, and it's windy like this, so we're used to it.
Yeah, and I suppose, I mean, you're 19, you know, you're quite young to be getting your first gold, and I suppose the focus now is for a good season, then looking towards Paris.
Yeah, definitely, yeah, it's crazy, but yeah, good season this time round, and yeah, we'll head for Paris.
I believe you're not with your phone, you want to get back to your phone, you reckon it's going to be going mad at the moment?
Yeah, definitely got to ring my dad, that's for sure.
Well, have a good party tonight, and enjoy your trip back home.
Thank you so much, take care now.
And that's Lucy Hall, who I said erroneously was in from Moulton in Derbyshire. She said very firmly, it's in Yorkshire, you know. So, Lucy, thank you very much. She'll
thank
go and enjoy her evening, I'm sure. And looking over the corner there, I can see the men are getting ready for their final. So that is coming up next.